I think, like, with regards to the joint partnerships that we have, that the Philippines has with China, is that what is that it's a, again, like what I've reiterated, it's a win-win situation, no? But now, what we have to be wary of is that we have to be clear on what the delineation is of projects, of what their tasks are in this way. But we have to also acknowledge that they have the technology to do this and that the Philippines stands to gain from this kind of exploration and this kind of partnership that we have. Because not only do they have the technology, but that technology can also be transferred through that interaction. And then perhaps we can also be independent in our own explorations at the end of the day. But with the territorial disputes, I believe that we should still have a code of conduct that has been reiterated by President Xi Jinping, by President Duterte, that we should act accordingly and
but
act with respect.
But isn't this code of conduct easier said than done? I mean, the ASEAN partners have all expressed the need for a code of conduct in the West Philippine Sea or in the China, you know, China, whatever they want to call it. But the thing is, it's easier said than done. Am I not correct?
You're very, very correct. It's just that at least we have a foundation already, and it's a work in progress. Because right now, we have to acknowledge the transition between the previous administration and the administration now, that before they were blocking our bananas from their ports, that they were just rotting there and that rotting in the Chinese ports. But now now our market is more open between China and therefore more jobs for the Filipinos, more income, the higher the GDP because of this relationship. So,
no, but what about our relationships with other nations? Because you're talking about a code of conduct for the South China Sea, okay, now, or for the West Philippine Sea. Now, that's fine, but the question is, Vietnam has a say. Malaysia has a say. All these other countries have a say, and what they're saying is, we don't trust the Chinese, we don't deal with the Chinese.
What? In my humble opinion, what the ASEAN should do is stand together and not only fight it or deal with it bilaterally, but in an ASEAN as one strong organization and in relations with the Chinese. So that it's not mistaken, that it's not, this is the Chinese deal with the Philippines. This is a Chinese deal with Vietnam. We want a stronger ASEAN in facing China. And perhaps that would contribute to the code of conduct that has been set, the peaceful coexistence that has been set by China in the beginning. I think in one of the speeches of President Xi Jinping.